Prachina Museum. It was established in the year 2000. We established this museum after a lot of consideration. In fact, I had finished my college and I was like trying to figure out what to do in life. And I chanced upon a meeting with Professor Jyotindra Jain at the Crafts Museum. And we both discussed a lot of ideas. And somehow we decided that we are going to establish a book, or we'll write something about Bikaner, or we will do something which is related with the culture here. Then slowly, slowly our ideas evolved and we decided that, you know, we are going to open a museum and we are going to start from a karkhana, which means a workshop. So I haven't opened a palace which has been turned into a museum. I have opened a workshop which has been turned into a museum. So the workshop was given to my grandmother by her late father-in-law, Maharaja Sadul Singh Ji, and that became a custom. So when my mother got married, even she was given a karkhana, that is a workshop. So we decided, let's work on this karkhana. So we entered that place. I entered for the first time, living in Bikaner for so many years. And we saw lots of cows, we saw lots of like junk, we saw lots of dust, we saw lots of rats, crows, and we decided, ki, all right, this is the place where I'm going to start a museum. And Professor Jyotindra Jain did not give up on the idea, and he arrived bang on time, and we went inside the building and we started to clean it up, we started to paint, we started to, you know, like get systematic galleries, and we bounced the idea to my grandmother, who is Siddhi Kumari ji of Bikaner, and she said, you know, let's do it. And she was very kind, like, let's take the collections of my family, like she comes from Dungarpur, and my mother also very supportive, she comes from Chamba. So it is a three generation women effort to establish Prachina. It goes without saying that it is my grandmother, Sushila Kumari ji, my mother, Padma Kumari ji, and me, we all three decided that yes, we have to start systemizing the procedure of starting the museum. So first we decided on the objects. Some were, most of my objects are family collection. So first my grandmother gave some objects, then my mother gave some objects, and then I had some objects, and we decided to do an everyday art museum with systematic galleries, with objects which showcase the modern and the conservative Rajas of Bikaner, the women of Bikaner, the royal women of Bikaner. A lot of paraphernalia goes for the women and the clothing and the robes they wore at during that time, and how it transformed, like what happened, what were the influences which came in, and what happened with those influences, and how it influenced the royal family in Bikaner, especially the women. So we decided to put up these systematic galleries. Then we started to bring in the influences of these women. One was from Dungarpur and one was from Chamba, and they both arrived, got married in Bikaner, and they brought in some very nice cultural influences, whether it was the French manicure sets or the lots and lots of colors of poshaks, which were the traditional Rajasthani dresses. And my mom brought in the Chamba influence, which is a Himachali Dogri type of influence. So we put in a lot of costumes together, and we made it a very composite costume gallery. Then we wanted to expand, we wanted to, you know, like figure out that we've finished a decade of Prachina. So after a decade, we wanted to do more. So we then decided to do furniture and silver, which is largely from my father's home, Narendra Bhavan. And that was where he lived, and that is what he used. And it was best to showcase his memory of Narendra Singh into my museum. So the best way I could do was to hang in those memories I had of my father. And I hung them in perpetuity in my museum. And we decided to do furniture and silver. Then we did lots and lots of wall paintings. The wall paintings were inside the karkhana. So that had a very like dark green color on top. And you know, like when we went in, that dark green color we wanted to wash. So once we washed the color, we saw the whole wall was full of Rangabaji and paintings. So there again, we manifested our own artists, and we gathered two more galleries, and that way, slowly, we started doing the locomotives, and we started the Rangabaji, which became a very special section, because it was hidden for 10 years after even establishing my museum. You know, the Rangabaji and the wall paintings was hidden. It had a very gaudy green color. So when that got washed, so they were like, I had ready made two galleries, so we decided not to touch anything inside the gallery, and we decided to wash the paint itself and restore the Rangabaji work. So that way, that's how Prachina's concept developed. That is what it is. It is a vision of three women, three generations, which live in Dalgarh, Bikaner, and we are here to showcase how the women celebrated that life and how it manifested in the daily life in Bikaner. So please, please, you know, when you think of Prachina Museum, you think about today's women, you think about the Rajput women, the kind of emancipation they had, you know, like my grandmother, my mother, who are like institutions who work tirelessly to showcase and preserve culture of Bikaner. And that is the heritage they both have passed on to me. And that is what Prachina stands for today.